Here's a bonus tip right off the bat. The first thing you want to do to improve Apple Watch battery life is to check your watch battery's health. So, from your Apple Watch, head to Settings, then Battery, and then Health. Here, you'll find your battery's maximum capacity. Generally, anything over about 80% means your battery is still in good shape. Also on this screen, ensure the optimized battery charging option is enabled, which it should be by default. So are you ready to get into 5 Apple Watch battery saving tips? Then let's go. Hey friends, I'm Tasia Custody and welcome back to my YouTube channel where I share tech tips and app reviews. So let's jump in right where we left off and troubleshoot your Apple Watch battery woes. So I know I gave you a bonus tip off the top, but I'm gonna give you even more bonus tips at the end after we cruise through these 5 tips for you. So tip number 1 to improve Apple Watch battery life. And no, it's not gonna be just stop waking up your display so frequently. Can't you control yourself? Instead, tip number 1 is to ensure your watch OS is up to date. You won't believe how this can help your watch's battery life. Sometimes there are bugs in software releases that can wreak havoc on your battery life through no fault of your own. So ensuring your watch OS is up to date to the latest version can really help your battery out. So there are a couple ways to update or check that your watch OS is up to date. First, from your Apple Watch, head to Settings, then General, and then Software Update. Or you could even do this from your iPhone by heading to the Watch app and then selecting General and then Software Update. It's really that easy. Apple Watch battery saving tip number 2, disable background app refresh. Just like on iPhone, Apple Watch is automatically set to update apps in the background even if they aren't open. And warning before we continue, if you disable background app refresh, some Apple Watch fitness data won't automatically sync to your iPhone. But lucky for you, you can pick and choose which apps you want to refresh in the background. Just head to the Watch app on iPhone and select General, then background app refresh. Now from here, simply disable any apps you don't want to refresh in the background. Tip number 3 to help your battery life is to enable a sleep schedule. Now, this is something I've actually had enabled for quite a few years now, and initially just did it as a way to get some peace and quiet when I'm sleeping and not have my phone going off all the time. Because when you enable a sleep schedule, Sleep Focus, which used to be part of Do Not Disturb mode, is automatically enabled for certain times. And what happens on one device happens on the other, meaning a major battery saving tip. You can enable a sleep schedule from your health app on your iPhone. Just scroll down to select sleep, and then here's where you'll see any sleep schedules you already have set up, or you can add a sleep schedule under full schedule and options. So I'm gonna tap on options here to show you that Sleep Focus is auto-enabled with this sleep schedule. So here, I've also got the sleep screen option auto-enabled. So notifications are snoozed and the screen will go to sleep as soundly as you. And if you're finding value in this video, please remember to give it a like and consider subscribing to my channel for even more content like this. Can you believe it? Okay, moving on to Apple Watch battery tip number 4, adjust Siri settings. Now, this doesn't mean you have to turn off Siri completely, though you can, no offense, girl. So to tweak or fully disable Siri on Apple Watch, you can head to the Watch app on iPhone or the settings section from your Apple Watch. So from here, just select Siri. Now here you can either disable everything or pick and choose which options you want to disable. So I would recommend starting with the raise to speak feature since I find that a little bit glitchy anyway. Or if you don't use Siri all that much, you could disable the listen for the wake word option too. And last but not least, well, besides the bonus tips at the end, tip number 5 for how to improve Apple Watch battery life is to disable unnecessary notifications. Yeah, you know the ones that you get all day long that you don't really need? Turn those off! From the Watch app on iPhone, head to Notifications, and from here, scroll down to the Mirror iPhone Alerts From section, and then just disable any apps that you don't need notifications from on your Apple Watch. Now remember, this is just stopping the notifications on your Apple Watch, not in general on your iPhone. And as promised, here are two bonus tips coming in hot. Bonus tip number one, disable the always on display. Now this tip is for Series 6 and higher. I happen to like the always on display, but if you don't and you're struggling with battery life issues, just head to the Watch app on iPhone and select display and brightness. Then tap always on, and here simply disable the feature. You can also do this from your Apple Watch settings as well. It's also found under the display and brightness option. And bonus tip number two, and this is controversial, you can enable power saving mode for workouts. Now there's a caveat with this bonus tip, which hence why it's a bonus tip, a Hail Mary, if you will, and wasn't featured on the main tip list. Enabling power saving mode during workouts will disable the heart rate sensor for certain workouts. So it'll surely save you battery life, but it's not gonna track the calories burned as accurately. So if you still wanna proceed, wow, you must be really desperate. Here's how to enable power saving mode. Head to the Watch app on iPhone and then select workout. And from here, simply enable power saving mode. Could it get any easier than that? So that's how to improve Apple Watch battery life. What do you think of these five Apple Watch battery saving tips? Let everyone know in the comments below. As always, thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, well, I want to know, so give it a like, a share, or leave that comment below. You can click right about here to subscribe to my channel, and here and here for even more content like this. Thanks so much for watching. See you next time.